What on earth is a limit? And why is it so important in the field of calculus? Well, first of all, we mean the limit of a function at a particular value. If you recall, functions can be graphed like this, where every point on the curve has an x value and y value. The only requirement for it to be a function is if for every x value, there is only one y value. In other words, if you're drawing the curve from left to right, you can't go back. Now then, what is the limit of a function at a particular x value, which for convenience we could call a? A limit is a number on the y-axis. If, as the x values approach a from both sides, the graph also appears to meet at a particular y value, then that is the limit of the function. The limit of f of x, the function, as x approaches a. There are two important things to note about limits. First, is that the limit at a only exists if it is approached from both sides of the number a in question. Think of it as double-checking your work on both sides to see if it was done correctly, like approaching the perfect serving amount from both sides. Second is that when we are finding the limit at a, we are only concerned with values very close to the number a, but not a itself. It doesn't matter if the limit is not the same as the y value at a, or even if a has no value. Now, some counterexamples. Here, the limit does not exist. Here, the limit also does not exist. Here, you could say that it tends to negative infinity, but since that's not a real number, the limit does not exist. Now then, why is the limit the so-called linchpin of calculus? Well, it's because most of the problems that calculus tries to solve can be defined as limits of a particular function. For example, let's look at this curvy wave. How can we draw a line from this point that perfectly captures the direction it was going for if it hadn't curved off? Well, since the slope of every line can be defined as the ratio of a vertical and a horizontal segment that it rests on, we can simply draw a line from our point to any other point on the graph and bring them as close as possible, letting the side lengths approach zero. Obviously, when they have no length, we can't calculate the ratio, so we simply get the limit of the amount of slant the line appears to be approaching as its side lengths tend to zero. Another is getting the areas of curvy objects. For example, for this curve, we can say that the area is the limit that the sum of the areas of these approximate regions, the squares, would approach as they get smaller and smaller in size, increasing in number, and thus become more accurate to the true area. Well, if there's one thing to take away from this, I guess it is that, in the context of limits at least, it's the journey that's more important than the destination. Thank you for watching. And I hope that you learned something today.